What's going on, everybody? Happy Saturday on Ambiguity. It is Saren here. I normally post on Sundays, and I will be posting tomorrow as well, but I have been MIA, in case you haven't noticed, for the past three weeks. And so I really wanted to just quickly catch you all up, because last week's topic was updates, and I felt awful for not being here, but a lot has been going on, an insane amount, and, you know, both internally and in the world, but a lot of stuff just in my head. But I'm just gonna do some updates for y'all just to keep you in the loop and get back in touch, because I really do miss posting. But I'm now 6 months and 11 days on T, so I'm a little bit over half a year on testosterone now. And it's really cool to just see the changes coming. I'm also over 6 months post-op with Dr. Kathy Rumer. And even like I'm seeing so many changes like in my chest and my muscles, in my growth because of testosterone, so that's really cool to see. I'm also getting some hair here. I haven't shaved here, but I'm getting like weird, I'm not even gonna show you, whatever. I'm getting weird, long, random chin hairs. They're not even chin hairs, they're like neck hairs. I'm getting like one here, here. I'm also getting pimples, but that's life right now. That's life on testosterone. Also, dealing with, you know, a definite increase in anger and kind of dealing with how to express that. Not even anger, it's kind of, I don't get like angry. I get irritated and kind of am now unsure of like how to cope, how to deal with it. Some guys are like, oh, I can't cry since being on testosterone, but I can definitely cry. It's just like, it's a matter of how frequently. I don't cry much at all very much anymore. Instead, I will seek out other options. Like I'll take my dog for a walk or a run, or I'll write, or I'll draw, or I'll smoke some weed, or you know, I'll figure something else out to do other than cry, or you know, physically like rage and you know, let that testosterone get to me. But yeah, that's what's going on there. So just a lot of personal stuff has been happening, and I apologize for being absent. But some other things that I'm going on that have been going on, and you know, mentally and, you know, physically, emotionally, whatever. I've been dealing with, like, this is a good thing. This is a positive thing. I've been, you know, the way my self-perception has definitely changed since being on testosterone. And, like, it's very comforting to know that I'm now being read as male and I'm now being recognized. It's just a really good feeling. But then what comes with this feeling is kind of a re-socialization. So, you know, I was socialized as what society would perceive to be a girl. So I was conceived as a girl growing up, and that's what everyone thought I was. So, you know, I was taught the gender roles and expectations that go along and coincide with being a girl. A cisgender girl is what I was perceived to be. So, you know, even saying that I was socialized as a girl, I don't like saying that, because what does that even mean to be a girl? You know what I mean? Because trans women were not socialized as cis women. Anyways, I'm going on a tangent. But anyways, I was socialized as a cisgender woman and treated as such. So now that I'm changing and you know, I'm not constantly out about being trans to everyone that I interact with, it's definitely caused some interesting situations where, you know, I'll be, you know, with a few friends and a dude will say something to me that I'm not okay with, and it's like, what the fuck do I do? You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to constantly be that guy who's, you know, interrupting and, like, being like, hey, maybe you need to check yourself, whatever. So I just kind of drop hints in there. But it's something that I'm, like, learning how to do and learning how to do comfortably. But yeah, there's a lot that comes with being what one perceives to be a white, heterosexual, cis male. You know, I'm saying this is what people initially read me as, and you know, to my knowledge, people who are not conscious or aware of the queer community, because you know, I'll meet someone and they know that I have a girlfriend and they immediately assume I'm male, and it's like, oh wow, heterosexual, you know, heteronormativity and all these assumptions that accompany that. So yeah, just engaging with people who perceive me to be a cis white male, it's very interesting, and it's a lot of times very uncomfortable because they just say really fucked up things, honestly, you know, and it's like, how do I combat that? How do I deal with that in a way that won't come off as, you know, jumping down their throat, which I find myself doing a lot now. So, or at least I think that I'm doing it, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes it's a lot harder to actually say something than to think it, or like, expect to say it. I don't know. I don't even know how to articulate this. Whatever. I'm exhausted. I'm making hard cider though right now. I love fall. Fall is my favorite season. I hope you're all enjoying the changing leaves and the cool weather. Fun fact about me, I literally hate the heat. So this is, and I don't know if this derives from like having to wear a binder when I was growing up and whatever, but I just love fucking winter and I love the cold weather because yeah, my theory is, you know, you can always be warmer if you have, if you know, I shouldn't say it, but like if you have sweaters and such, because I don't like to have the heat on. Anyways, I like to just cuddle in blankets and shit. But anyways, but also like in the summer, like I hate sweating like down there, and then I can't pack and I can't bind and whatever, you know, back in the days. But yeah. So I'm excited. I'm in a good place, I think. I'm just dealing with a lot of like emotional shit going on. But ways that I'm kind of trying to cope are I'm drawing a lot more and I'm hanging out with people a lot more and I'm focusing on my work. I'm also putting together this queer documentary at my school, running this trans group at my school, and leading our queer group on campus this semester, which is pretty cool. It's definitely a highlight of my week. You know, we have these discussions that are facilitated around, you know, queer topics, and it's a good time. I think I'm in a good place, but it's still, you know, transitioning is hard. So moral of this video, things are hard, but it's going all right. And I love you all. I'll probably be posting tomorrow on sex education, although I don't have too much to say, but I'm definitely going to be present because I have not been in the past few weeks. So I love you all. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up on Tumblr or Facebook. I might not respond as soon as you would like, but I read all my questions. And the best way to contact me is on sarengray.tumblr.com. Okay, I love y'all. Bye.